Good afternoon, everybody. It's pop-up time. We pop up and you pop in. Detroit, Michigan just popped in. God bless you. Philadelphia, Pennsylvania just popped in. Orange, Texas, wow, just popped in. I'm good. Memphis, Tennessee just popped in. We popped up and you popped in. Where you popping in from? Portage, Indiana just popped in. God bless you. Blessings. What city, what state, what country are you popping in from? We popped up and you popped in. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania just popped in. God bless you. Stockton, California just popped in. God bless you. Lancaster, Texas just popped in. God bless you. Banning, California just popped in. God bless you, Overseer. How are you, precious? I pray all is well with you. We popped up and you popped in. Deborah, what of the night? Don't forget to invite. Don't forget to share. We know it's Saturday and everybody is out and doing what needs to be done for their family. But however, we're still going to get this word out. I miss you too. I miss you too. I'll be coming to California real soon. God bless everybody popping up. We popped up and you pop in. Yes, where you popping in from? What city, what state, what country are you popping in from? We're going in about two more minutes, or not two more minutes, but 10 more seconds. We're going in. We want to have some time with this one. This is the conclusion of the matter. Deborah, what of the night? Blessings to everyone. Okay, will do. I will. I'll message you and let you know. But we are headed to California in a few weeks. Blessings. Houston just popped in. God bless you, precious. Stockton, California just popped in. God bless you. Deborah, what of the night? We going in a few seconds. We are glad to see everyone. Everyone is doing well. Blessings, Evangelist Marlon Thompson. God bless you, precious. What city, what state, what country have you popped in from? Bronx, New York. God bless you. Yes. Columbus, Ohio, God bless you. Thank you for popping in. Yes, I sure will oversee. I'll let everyone know. God is blessing here in Texas. Detroit, Michigan just popped in. God bless you. Good evening. Where you popping in from? In about a few seconds, we're going in. We are in Texas and we're excited. Houston, we headed to you next month. Yes. Memphis, Tennessee just popped in. God bless you. Chattanooga, Tennessee just, oh, well, all right, Tennessee popping in. Chattanooga, Tennessee, God bless you. Thank you for popping in. You loving the hair? Y'all know I got to do something. I always got to do something different. Y'all know how I am. Fort Worth, Texas just popped in. Yes. Y'all know I have short hair, but that doesn't stop me. Yes. Wisconsin just popped in. God bless you. Tampa, Florida, we see you. Thank you for popping in. Yes, is there anything specific you want us to pray for? Let it be known. Arlington, Texas, God bless you. Just popped in. Yes. Chicago in the house. Windy City just popped in. God bless you. Thank you for joining us. Well, in about 1 second, we are going in. Yes, we are. Don't forget to share, to invite Deborah. What of the night? Spring, Texas. My daughter is on. God bless you. Yes. Wisconsin, God bless you. My God, look at God. Wisconsin just popped in. God bless you. You're still trying to do this football ministry. Well, we're going to pray. Clarity, yes. Yes. Fayetteville, North Carolina just popped in. God bless you. Yes, we will surely pray. Yes. Yes. Well, bless you. Bless you. Bless you, Simeon. God bless you. Thank you for popping in. California's popped in. Amen. God bless you. You ready for part three? This is part two. We on part three, Pastor Loretta, part three. Yeah, this is part three. The first part was on Tuesday. You only can really hear that one. We are on part three. I believe that is part three. Yes, because we did it Wednesday. Yes, this is part three. Amen, 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 amen. Well, praise the Lord, everybody. And as everyone, amen, begin to check in to all those that are checking in and not really saying anything, but we do send love, kisses, and hugs all around the world. We are family on this channel. This is our pop-up. We will pop up anytime. Don't forget, on Sundays at 12:30 is our high noon worship service, and we're excited for what God is doing, amen, at that particular time. Also, to all of the H online campuses, don't forget to be connected in. Bring people in with you. We are getting ready to do some awesome things for the kingdom of God. On Tuesday night is our Millionaires Club, which is Bible expansion. Are you here with me? And on Wednesday at 6 a.m. is our weather forecast channel. And we are excited for what the Lord is doing for all of us, for the entire body of Christ. And we can't get so caught up Amen. In the blessings of the Lord, we can't get so caught up in the promises of the Lord. We can't get so caught up in all that is happening to us from God that we begin to not stay, amen, on alert. So Deborah, what of the night? And so we're getting ready to go into this. This is our third, and we're getting ready to climax this. And I say to you, if you have not seen part two or part one, now part one, if you go to look at part one, the enemy surely did not both times, did not want us to teach this, but you know, we're going to obey God and do what God has called us to do. So on part one, if you have not, amen, took yourself there to really, it's really hearing, then if you look at to look, you won't really see it because the enemy kept messing with it and didn't want us to tape it and anything of that nature. But however, you can hear it real clear, and the Lord told me to go ahead and keep it there, and I kept it right there. So part one is on there. Part two is on there. That is from Wednesday Weather Forecast Channel, and now this is part three. And I thank God for you and you chiming in for such a time as this into the pop-up. And I know on Saturdays you have a busy schedule. I know as well we are all on different time schedule, and so I'm honored and surely I am humbled. But we're getting ready to get into the meat of this. This is part three, and we hopefully are going to finalize this on today. Deborah, what of the night? It's found in the book of Judges, chapter 4. Judges chapter 4 is where I found a scripture. And there were two other scriptures, but we're getting ready, amen, to really dive into Judges chapter 4. So Judges chapter 4, verse 4 and 5, the Bible decrees the word of God to be so. And Deborah, a prophetess, the wife of Lephidoth, she judged Israel at that time. And she dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah between Ramah and Bethel in Mount Ephraim. And the children of Israel came up to her for judgment. That is Judges chapter 4, verse 4 and 5, okay? Let me go ahead and read this. Deborah, her name means bee. She's a wife. She's a prophetess who served Israel during the time of Judges. Deborah's role as a commander and a chief reflect the highly superior activities. And you could go back into part two and to part one, where the Lord gave us revelation on her being a commander and a chief. Are you hearing me? And literally a judge. So you need to go back into those different teachings so you can get some clarity, insight, and understanding that we did go into the meat of it about Deborah. Deborah was not just a prophetess, precious. She was a judge as well. Not only was she a judge, but she was a commander and a chief that reflects highly, watch this, superior activities, not in the earth, but in the realm of the spirit. Are you hearing me? And not only in the realm of the spirit of in the heavenlies, but where the demonic forces have activities. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? And to everyone that is joining in, send kisses and love, hugs all around the world. Love you. We're going into Judges chapter 4, verse 4. Come on and join me. Here we go. You know that activities dealing with the third realm, the second realm. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? Watch this. She delegated to her. She was a delegate. You have to understand. I'll get into that. I don't want to go too fast. Delegated to her to indicate she functioned more as an apostolic. She functioned more in the apostolic, just like Moses. Watch this. The word judge means shaphat. That's S-H-A-P-H-A-T, shaphat, which is a type of judge. Get that? A type of judge, okay? A type of judge. She also would train up the coming apostles, or the train up the coming prophets. Are you hearing me? Samuel was another prophet, and he was also a judge. And you can find it in 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 20, chapter 7, verse 15 and 17, and it will give you clarity. You have to understand, all prophets must know their functions. All prophets have access to a whole lot of things in the realm of the heavenly. You have to know your function. And if you want to understand that even more, go to part two, and you would get some clarity and some understanding. All right, Deborah, what of the night? So we just dealt with Deborah. Let's talk about the night. That word night in the biblical sense is a spiritual sense, which signifies a state of shade brought on by falsity from evil. brought on by falsity from evil. If it's false, come on here, then it cannot be what? Truth. It is brought on by falsity of evil. So when you begin to understand night, not just literally when you get nighttime outside, and now we're saying, glory to God, that this night, the enemy, no, we have to understand things can be going well in your life, and it could be nighttime, but guess what? Just because it's nighttime, you have to understand, glory to God, and all things are going well in your life, you still need to know what is going on in the night place. Watch this. In the second realm, what is the enemy up to in the second realm? Are you hearing me? And so, glory to God, don't worry about that. That's my dryer going forth. We still got to live and do what, you know, supposed to be done. So if you hear all that noise, that's my dryer going. Spiritual sin signifies a state of shade brought on by falsity from evil. Also, obscurity. Now watch this. Obscurity, that means the state of not being known. The state of not being known. Glory to God. You got to understand, the Lord don't just want to reveal to us what he's doing for us, but the Lord wants to reveal to us what the enemy is up to, that he would try to take us out. Is anybody listening, or did everybody go home? Now, watch this. Night, it also means, watch this, mainly of the mind, ignorance of truth. It means death. Darkness of the soul or lost faith. So when we're talking about the night, are you listening? When we're talking about the night, we're not talking about it's now nighttime outside, because right now it's daylight outside. And we're not talking about that. We're talking about the obscurity, what has not been revealed, what has not been known yet. That's what we are talking about. Is anybody listening, or did everybody go home? Watch this. So night also means death. It also means loss of soul. It means loss of faith or darkness of soul. Are you hearing me? And so I want you to understand, Deborah, what of the night? Where we are at in the realm of the spirit, or where we at in our life, in our time span, because everybody should know we're about to check up out of here. Are you hearing? I know we've heard this years and years and years and years and years and years and years, but for real, we're about to check up out of here. Glory to God. And the enemy knows that time is quickly winding up. And so what he is doing, and you can see it in the natural, you can see it now in the natural, anything you can see in the natural, those that, watch this, are saved but can't see, and those that are not saved and can see in the natural, glory to God, you can see things that are happening in the natural, but it's not what's happening in the natural that we should be really, I wouldn't say not concerned, because we can pray about that, because we can see that. But it's what we cannot see that is already manifesting itself. That's the part that I want to zero in on regarding Deborah, what of the night. And we're going to be shouting, and we're going to be falling out on the altar and throwing cloths, and don't even realize that the enemy has set camp in our house. And that the enemy has set camp in our body, that the enemy has set camp in our marriages, that the enemy has set camp in our business. It's time now. You need to know. You need to have the upper hand. Are you hearing me? I first stated, glory to God, and you can look on there and you can see, I first stated why everybody is pointing at Trump. And listen, I'm not giving him a go pass. I'm not giving him a go pass. But what I am saying, while all eyes is on Trump and all eyes is on him and saying, look at him and this, that, and the other, it's not him. It's what you can't see that is behind him, not behind him pushing him. But what else? What is behind him? Because he's the distraction. Are you hearing me? Trump is the distraction. Trump is the distraction, because all this stuff he's doing, and guess what? Everybody is seeing it, whether you're saved or not, whether you can see in the spirit realm or not. Everybody can do what? Can see it. Are you hearing me? So that's not what we're talking about. There is something that is about to hit the earth, glory to the Shanda, that we if we don't get into alignment with God and we don't get ourselves equipped with God, we're going to go down like everybody else. Y'all not saying nothing. Well, Apostle, I don't get this. How can you say that? Well, I'm so glad that you asked, because when the Lord says to Moses to go and tell the children of Israel, I'm going to come, because it's getting ready to be Passover, I'm going to come and I'm going to visit Egypt. But I'm not coming to visit Egypt, amen, to have a vacation with them. I'm coming because it's time for you to be released. But I'm coming and I'm going to have to deal with some things while you're in your release mode. Then he says, who is he? The Lord says to Moses, tell the people this is what they must do, because if they don't do it, they're going to be wiped out with, my God, from Zion, with Egypt. Are you hearing me? So the Lord gave Moses instructions about what the children of Israel needed to do in order for their lives to be saved, while the Lord is going to come and do what? To wipe them out. So what am I saying? I'm telling everybody, and I'm blowing the trumpet. I'm telling you, before this year is out, something major is going to hit this earth. I said something major is going to hit this earth. Now watch this. It does not have to take the children of God by surprise. Are you hearing me? And how will it not take us by surprise? Because we will prepare ourselves for what is coming. If we don't prepare ourselves for what is going to hit this land, y'all not saying nothing, then guess what? It's going to wipe us out as well. Deborah, what of the night? So I want you to go back and look at those clippings and really hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. We're doing a lot of preaching, and thank God for that. And we're doing a lot of prophesying, and thank God for that. But baby, glory to God, I need to know what is going on. I need to know what I need to do. I need to know what I need to get rid of. I need to know what I need to add to my life. Come on here, because I don't want to be wiped away in a time that the enemy is going to have rampage. Are you hearing what I'm saying? The enemy is going to have rampage. And we need to have the upper hand. We need to be seeing it. You don't need to see a house, glory to God, when there's a great flood. Y'all got that? You don't need to see a car, come on here, when there's a great fire. Are y'all getting that? You don't need to see something of the natural when something natural is going to take place in the earth. You need something from the realm of the Spirit, from God, that will protect you and me and our family, because we are the children of God. And let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. When the prophets prophesied famine, do you think they were not in the famine? Well, when they prophesied the famine, the prophets was also in the famine. But what happened was God took care of them. They was not all on some other island where the famine was. No. They was in the midst of the famine, but the famine could not take them over. Are you hearing me? And so as long as you're on the earth and as long as you're still breathing, if this thing that is about to hit in 2018 on the land, if we don't get in God for real, if we don't begin to say prophets, because this is Deborah, what of the night? If we don't start saying prophets, what of the night? Not a car, not a house, not a job, not a promotion. All of those things are in its prospective place. But I need to know what is behind, amen. The enemy is up to something. While all eyes is on Trump, there is something that the enemy is conjuring up that, watch this, if those that are not in the realm of the Spirit, we won't be able to see. If we can't see, we cannot come and forewarn. And if we cannot come to forewarn because we cannot see, then all of us will be wiped out. And that's not the will of God. So when I say Deborah, Peshaka, what of the night? I'm talking about of the place of the demonic forces of what is being conjured up against the children of God. Do you think that the enemy loves us? The enemy does not love us. He wants to wipe us out. Are you listening to me? Especially to your, to you all that are saved and sold out. Are you hearing me? He's out for us. He's out for us. But as long as we got people that the Lord, glory to God, has put as a watchman. Now watch this. I don't have time to go back and teach this. That's why you got to go to part two, because you can be an intercessor watchman, but that doesn't mean you are a watchman in the prophetic of a judge. That's why you got to go to part two and go back and listen to it. Because I don't want you to like, well, yep, that's who I am. I'm a watchman on a tower. There's all different type of towers in the realm of the spirit that are standing. All type of towers. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. And the tower that I'm talking about today, glory to God, is not just a watchman at the Boshaya, but I'm talking about the one that God has called to be a judge. Are you hearing me? Oh my God. Deborah was a prophetess and she was a judge. She was commander and she was a chief. Watch this. She was a chief of the activities. She understood the activities. Not only did she understand that, she was a commander. Watch this. She knew how to array the army and she knew how far the war should go. That's why you got to go to part two. Because if I go there, then I stay there, then I'll never get to part three. Are you hearing me? So you have to understand, glory to God, Deborah, what of the night? She was a judge. So what am I saying? The Lord is about to reveal, glory to God, not just prophets, but prophets that he's called to be judges. Are you hearing me? Which not just can command a day, but command and array the people. Glory to God, in wartime, watch this, and to say how far the war is supposed to go. Are you hearing me? Again, because let me go ahead and throw this scripture out real quick, because the Lord says to Satan, where are you going? From the book of Job, going to help you out real quick. Where are you going? Where are you going, Satan? Satan said, I'm going to and fro, seeing whom I can devour. The Lord said, watch what he says. Have you thought about or considered my servant Job? Watch what Satan says. He said, no. Why? Because you have a hedge around him. You have a protection, a shield around him. Watch what God says. He said, you could touch everything of Job but his soul. So then what was God doing at this particular time? He was telling Satan how far he can go in the war. Pashanda. How far he can go in the war. Yes, I know that the battle is not ours. It belongs to the Lord. But I need you to come out into the deep. I don't need you to stay in the shallow water. You stayed in the shallow water long enough. You know that scripture. Are you hearing me? But there's so much more of God. There's so much more of the kingdom of God. There's so much more of the revealing of God. There's so much more to God. Glory to God. That we're going to have to understand. We need to understand. God, give me deeper depth. For the Bible says the deep call it for the deep things of God. And if there's deep things of God, then it got to be surface things of God. Well, come on here, scripture. The Bible says, glory to God, that my God, we should have already graduated from elementary. That means repentance. That means don't do that. Stop doing that. Stop going there. You know, that's elementary. We supposed to have already matured from that. But a lot of us, we can't get to the deep things of God because we still in elementary. Are y'all getting this? And so, yes, beloved, the scripture says that the battle is not mine. It belongs to the Lord. But I need to understand, too, that when the war is on, how far can the enemy go in this war? So Deborah knew how long the war was supposed to last. If the enemy is coming in and God has allowed him to touch your body, because God is going to heal your body. Don't you know the enemy does not try to play fair? And if you and I don't stay on alert, he'll touch the body. He'll go from the body to the marriage. He'll go from the marriage to the children. He'll go from the children. Come on, somebody, to your ministry. You see what I'm saying? But when you know how far he's supposed to go, come on, somebody, then you rebuke him. Are you hearing me? So Deborah, glory to God, was a commander. She was a military prophetess. Ooh, God, I got to get me a towel. My God, from Zion. Ooh, are y'all getting this? Araboshana. She was a military prophet, knowing how to array the people. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Knowing how to array the people and telling them how long the war was supposed to last. In other words, glory to God, the enemy is going to come and tamper with this. Are you hearing me? But we're going to walk by faith and not by sight. Are you hearing me? Lord have mercy. The Lord is talking to me. Do you remember when Jesus was tried in three different points of his life? Are you hearing me? And the Spirit of the Lord ran him into the wilderness. Do you remember that? Well, let me tell you something. The enemy will try to go further if we don't be on alert and know how far he's supposed to go. Are you hearing me? So when the enemy, Satan, come on here, the devil, come on here, tried to tempt Jesus, glory to God, the Bible said he tempted him in three points of his life. Are you hearing me? Spirit, come on here, flesh, come on here, and mind. Are you hearing me? But don't think that the enemy wouldn't have went on further. Are you hearing me? But Jesus put him in his place. All right, you tempt me in three points of my life. That's it. Come on here, somebody. He said, that's it. The war, amen, of this season is over. You're not going to go into, amen, other areas of my life that you were not ordained to go into. Is anybody listening? Or did everybody, are y'all understanding what God has said? Because I got to get to this. She was a military prophetess. She was a judge. She was a commander and a chief, not just because we put chief, amen, in our titles. She was a chief because she can walk in and know the activities of the demonic forces, the activities of what's going on in the heavenlies. Are y'all getting this? My God, from Zion. Woo! Are y'all okay? Is everybody on the same page with me? Glory to his wonderful name. So Deborah, what of the night? Let me tell you something. We need to know what. I went to a service last night, and y'all know I just be me, because when God talk, I'm just going to be me. You know, how about Shonda? And the man of God was literally saying that a stronghold, because it was a deliverance conference, and that was truly a deliverance conference. It wasn't a deliverance conference when they got up there and started preaching, the praise team sung, the dancers danced, and then they prophesied that houses and cars and this and that, and then we went home. That was not that service. That service was surely a deliverance service. Yes, the praise team opened up, that glory to God, the ministering dancers were dancing up under the unction of the Holy Ghost, but my God, from Zion, when they hit that pulpit to minister, they ministered about deliverance. They ministered about, glory to the Most High, of demonic spirits. Are you hearing me? Oh my God. So last night, the man of God, Dr. Stephen Matthew Stevenson from Chicago, he was the one that was ministering. Apostle Gardner ministered Thursday night. All good, all God. Okay. And he was talking about the stronghold. Well, and he also was talking about the footsteppers, he shut up Ohio, which are those very things, the demonic spirits that have manifested itself. Let's say, for instance, sickness. Let's just take sickness, and you see the symptoms of it. That's the footsteppers. Well, it's not the footsteppers that are the stronghold. The stronghold is the one that is hiding. Are you hearing me? And if you don't know, glory to the Most High, if you don't have the Holy Ghost and the Lord has the Most High has not begun, or you have not allowed the Lord to work with you, you would not even realize which one is the strong man. You would think the footsteppers are the strong man, when reality is the strong man is not open, because the strong man does not want a man to be cast out. And let me go ahead and say it like this, because I need you to get with me. Deborah, what of the night? When the Lord Jesus Christ casted out, amen, the spirit from the person, and it went and went into dry land, okay? Yes, I like his ministry too. Hallelujah. And went into dry land where it couldn't find a resting place. It could not find a house. So guess what it did? It turned around and said, I'm going back home. The devil is crazy. He said, I'm going back home. Are you hearing me? But yet and still, the house was what swept and clean, but it was not what occupied. So guess what the demonic spirit, the stronghold did? The stronghold went and got seven other spirits. Are you hearing me? Why? Because the strong man or the stronghold, come on here, wants to hide. Are you hearing me? So while the other ones are, you know, in front and say, yep, that's the one, the stronghold that is holding that man hostage or that woman hostage is being hidden. So understand, when God, that man brought that, y'all know I just grabbed my towel. He got the towel anointed. Pam, 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 pam. Because that's what God was saying. Daughter, they need to know what of the night. They need to realize, glory to God, while they're seeing certain things, everybody is seeing the murdering spirit. Everybody is seeing it. Saved folks, unsaved. It's all on TV. The murdering spirit is having havoc. Are you hearing me? But there is something behind it that is that we don't see. Are y'all getting this? This is what the teaching is all about. Deborah, what of the night? Are you hearing me? Because when that spirit comes back into a man, it does not want to be cast out again, let alone it does not want to be noticed real quick. It will be hidden. Are you hearing me? So when he said that, I said, God, you are talking. This is what you told me. You told me to tell the people. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Church will not be as usual. Is anybody listening to me? Deborah, what of the night? Come on here. What of the night? What of the night? What of the night? What is it? Are y'all listening? Glory to his wonderful name. My God, Deborah, what of the night? John chapter 8 and verse 12. Let me go there. Let me put my paper up here for a second. John, we're going to go back to Judges. John chapter 8. Are y'all okay out there? Are y'all okay? Are y'all understanding? Now, you may not get the totality until you go to part one and part two. Okay? Because I need you to understand what I'm talking about. I need you to understand what I'm teaching on. What I'm teaching on is this, that Deborah, she was not just a regular prophet, and a lot of prophets, prophetess, is running out here and don't know their functions. Don't know, glory to God, their boundaries. Don't know where they have been set up in the realm. Are you hearing me? They're tapping into other places they have not have access to. Are y'all understanding what I'm telling you today? And I'm also letting you know that there are prophets, prophetess, that are considered judges. And if they are judges, come on here, they have a different function than regular prophets. I understand there is the office of the prophet. I know that. Come on here. Come on over here with me. I'm teaching what God is telling me to teach over here. I need you to realize, why would God pick Deborah? Why would God show us, amen, her life? Why would God say this? Before we get into the story, we'll dive into the story and miss the meat of what God was saying. Are you hearing me? We're going to, yeah, because you know she helped the king out, or she helped this one out, and that. No, no, no. We missed the meat of what God was saying. She was a judge. In other words, there are prophets that are judges. Edible Shia. And can I lift both of my hands and my feet up and tell you, I know that I am one. Go back to part one and part two, and you will know that I am one. Are you hearing me? But you're an apostle. Yes, I am. Glory to God. But I'm also a prophetess, and I am a judge. Are you listening to what God is saying? You have to understand rankings. A lot of us don't understand ranking. That's why the Lord said the children of darkness, they're more wiser because they understand ranking. We in the body of Christ, we everywhere. We're doing all type of stuff. We all in different regions. And talking about God don't give everybody every region. Are you hearing me? He don't give you every region. Some of you all could go in and you could preach and you could pray and you could do the certain things you can and you can't do in a region. Are you hearing me? Glory to his wonderful name. My God, from Zadadaboshaya. Woo, my Babasaya. So we're going to have to come on in. We can get up out of here. And not only will the church be prosperous, not only will the church be prosperous, but the church also is going to leave out of here in the right arrayed, in the right rankings, in the right place. Listen, you got children, you got mother, you got father. You got to know the rankings, okay? You got to know who is in, who's at the top, who's in the middle, and who's at the bottom. Are you hearing me? And you got to know your boundaries. Are y'all hearing me? But in the body of Christ, we're doing so much stuff. We grabbing titles, and we grabbing this, and we running. Glory to God, we have nobody, amen, to correct our ephods. You know, but God showed me, God told me, and I can say it, and I can do this, and da 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 shanda. No, I'm telling you something is about to come up on this earth. I'm telling you. And while everybody's looking at Ebo Shanda Trump, come on here. Glory to God. It's okay for the world to look at Trump. But we should be realizing, okay, you're a distraction. All this stuff is going on. There is something. There is something that's being conjured up by the enemy behind find him, not to push him, because what he is doing is what he is doing. There is something else that is about to arise. And please don't tell me the Antichrist. Y'all, come on. Come on. Y'all already know that. It's a time that he will be revealed. It's a time. What's happening is the functions of the different things is happening as an Antichrist. But the person, glory to God, that spirit has housed will be revealed at a certain time. Glory to God. Well, there is something else. Are y'all getting this? Are you understanding this? My God, from Zion. And so she was a military prophetess. That's why, glory to God, I began to look back. 2014, there was a man of God that the Lord gave him some words, and he typed it for me, and he wrote it down. And I'm looking in my Bible, and I pull out my papers, and I see, and I begin to read it. When I begin to read it the other day, he began to say in the letter, in that God was saying, that you are a militant person. You're a military person. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. In other words, God was already dropping nuggets. He gave me the dream. He showed me who I was. Then he started dropping nuggets. So when 2018 came and he began to give me this word to teach, glory to God, guess what? It is now time for it. Because why? God, all the way along the way of my journey, of my path, he was dropping nuggets. And while other people would look at me and say, she too strong or she too this, they didn't go to God and ask God, who is she? Why does she carry herself like this? Why does she minister the way she minister? Why does she do? Why would she talk the way she talk? Because when you are prophetess and you are judge and you have the oil of the anointed, glory to God, of the military, see, I'm not in a natural military. Are you hearing me? But I'm in the spiritual. Are you hearing me? And there's a ranking that comes with that. And so this is Deborah, and I need you to understand that this is Deborah, and there's a lot of prophets that are about to be sat down. There's a lot of churches that are about to be sat down, because the people that's in the pews, they are dying, and they are dying, glory to God, because the people in the pulpit don't have the power. The people in the pulpit don't know their rankings. The people in the pulpit don't want God to come in and to deliver his people. Y'all not saying nothing to me. Glory to his wonderful name. Deborah, what a the night. And it ain't a good teaching. It's good for those to say, you know what, God, I thank you. But to others, because they want to keep doing whatever they want to do, and oh, she trying to point me out. I didn't say nobody name. You didn't hear me say nobody name, but I did say the body of Christ. Are you hearing me? And I don't want to be around somebody that can't see stuff coming up on us. Didn't nobody see that? And I understand scripture that there are times that sometimes God will choose not to show things. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. That's in what God wants to do, how he wants to do it. But that's not all the time. And you mean to tell me we don't know? Amen. Glory to God. From from the demonic forces, from the rims and the rankings of what is going on. You mean to tell me we don't know? Everything always got to come upon us and overtake us. And then now we begin to minister. And then now we begin to pray. And then now we begin to cast. No, this thing has to be what? It has to be a totality of what God is saying. And it is what? It is time now. I told y'all to go to John chapter 8, did I not? John chapter 8. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. John chapter 8. What scripture? John chapter 8. John chapter 8. John chapter 8. My shall I say. John chapter 8, and we're going to verse 12. Let's see. The Bible decrees the word of God to be so. Then spake Jesus unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. Did y'all hear that? He that followed me shall not walk in darkness. Did y'all hear that? But shall have light of life. Did y'all hear that? So Jesus says that I am the light of the world. So then why would Jesus say he's the light of the world? Because there is some spirit that is in the earth. Is what? The darkness of the world. Are you hearing me? So Jesus came and said, I am the light of the world, because there is, glory to God, satanic, Satan, devils that are the darkness of the world. And if we walk with Jesus, he will begin to reveal what is happening in the dark. Are you hearing me? All right. Let's go to Matthew chapter 10. Go to Matthew chapter 10. Thank you, scribes. Thank you. Matthew chapter 10. So if Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, amen, our Redeemer, come on here, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, he says he is the light of the world. Why would he say that? Because there is a demonic spirit in the earth that is what? The darkness of the world. And if he's the light of the world, and if you walk with Jesus, then you have life because you have light. Are you hearing me? Then therefore, if the darkness, which is Satan, that's of the world, he's going to do what? Bring death. Lord, thank you for that. Matthew chapter 10. Let's go. Matthew chapter 10. Matthew chapter 10 and verse 26. Matthew chapter 10, verse 26. Fear them not, therefore, for there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, and hid that shall not be unknown. He said, fear them not. Are you hearing me? Therefore, for there is nothing covered that shall not be revealed, and hid that shall not be known. What I tell you in darkness, that ye speak in light. Oh, Messiah. Woo! And what you hear in the ear, that ye preach, or that preach ye upon the housetops. Can I say that again? Because I feel like shouting. About shout. Verse 27. Matthew chapter 10, verse 27. Watch. What I tell you in what? Darkness. Wait a minute. Wait, Jesus. But you are the light of the world. So whatever you telling me is from the light. He said, no, I am the light of the world. But what I'm going to reveal to you is what is hidden in the dark. Deborah, what of the night? Are y'all getting this? He says, what I tell you in darkness, that speak ye in light. No, that means he gonna tell it to you in private, apostle. That's what he mean. Woo, to you all that's out in the deep, we're going to stay in the deep and let the shallow stay in the shallow, okay? We're going to stay out here in the deep, okay? Glory to his wonderful name, Abba Shanda. Because darkness is darkness. Jesus already let us know he is what? He is the light of the world. Them that walk with him will walk in what? Light. And they will have what? Light in their life. Then Jesus is in Matthew chapter 10, verse 26. And he said, everything that is hid, everything, come on here, that is covered, is going to be what? Revealed. And he said, I'm going to do what? He said, what I tell you in darkness, that speak ye in what? In light. Yes, that means as well. Glory to God, he's going to do private. But I'm going to reveal that I'm Oshia, what the enemy has counted up. I'm going to reveal something, glory to God, that I will see, that shall come, that the enemy will try to do. And my judges, the prophets are going to begin to speak some things. Hala Oshia, and those that were here would take heed. And those, glory to God, that say, we already know this, we already got this, we already this, they will go down with everybody else. Come on here, somebody. And the Messiah. Ooh, watch this. He says, when I tell you in darkness that speak ye in the light, and what ye hear in the ear, that preach ye upon the housetops. So to preach it on the house, yes, Father. If you're going to preach it on the housetops, can y'all just talk to me? If I go outside now and go to my roof, because housetops is what? The roof, right? So if I'm going to preach it from the rooftop, then I'm going to be saying it to people that don't even understand God. Are you hearing me? And so for that reason, the Lord is going to reveal. I got scripture for you today. Glory to his wonderful name. He said, I'm going to start revealing the darkness. The darkness. See, we so stuck on God telling us something secret and private that we're missing. Glory to God. If Jesus is the light, then what is going on in the dark? Because he said, there is darkness and light. light shall shine in the midst of darkness. Shall shine in the midst of darkness. Because if you are in your house at night and you don't have no light on, you cannot see. Well, if you can't see, then you can't see even thing activities going on in the house. So if you got a cat or a dog and you don't hear them, and they're standing or sitting somewhere that they usually don't, and you don't have the light on, you just ran into them. Are you hearing me? And you almost tripped and you almost fell. Are you hearing me? And when you turned the light on, you would say to your little dog or your cat, why are you right there? You should have been over yonder. Are you hearing me? That is because you can't see in the dark. And if you could have known that they were right there, then you would have what? You would have already been forewarned, and then you would have did the necessary things so you wouldn't have ran into them nor stumbled over them. Are you getting this? Ooh. Oh, Jesus. Are y'all okay? Are y'all okay? Go to Genesis 18. I got to get to Deborah. Go to Genesis 18. Go to Genesis 18. Go to Genesis 18, 17. Genesis 18, 17. Genesis 18 and verse 17. Watch what he says. Genesis 18, verse 17. And the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham that thing which I do? This is the Lord talking to himself. Shall I hide? I'm going somewhere with this. Shall I hide what I'm about to do from my friend? Because he called Abraham his friend. I know right here, glory to God, it says, and the Lord, shall I hide from Abraham the thing which I do? But Abraham was considered God's friend. Are you hearing me? So now, the enemy can only mimic what he has saw and seen God do. Or saw and seen God say. He takes what he see and saw God do, and then he what? He begins to flip it, and he begins to pervert it. Now, if the Lord said, shall I reveal to Abraham what I'm about to do, which is hidden? Shall I reveal it to him? Watch this. So the enemy, glory to God, not God, the enemy is always trying to mimic God. Are you hearing me? So if the Lord said that, listen, then the enemy said, I'm going to hide some stuff, but watch this. I'm going to hide it so that those that are in the light cannot see it. Because whatever he does, he's going to do it in the dark. And so the Lord is saying, so shall I, what I'm about to do, shall I reveal it to Abraham? Are you hearing me? That's what the Lord said. So now flip the script. There are things that the enemy has plotted that he is saying they're not going to get this, because they're talking about houses and cars and talking about, amen, promotions and stuff. And that's why cancer is running in people's family. And that's why, amen, all type of stuff is just running racket through people's life, because we're so stuck on cars and houses that we don't understand, glory to God, that poverty is taking us out. All other stuff is taking us out. But if somebody could say, Deborah, what of the night? Because what is the enemy countering up? Rabashiah, glory to God. I love all she got. Reveal to me what the enemy is conjuring up for my family, what the enemy is conjuring up for my ministry, what the enemy is conjuring up for my marriage. Why? Because then I can go on the what? The housetop or the roof and begin to what? Begin to speak it out of my mouth to everybody. And those that hear will hear, and those that won't. Are you hearing me? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Deborah, what of the night? Are you getting that? So I brought the Genesis chapter 18, verse 17 to let you know, if God said that, if the Lord said, what I am doing, shall I keep this hidden from my friend Abraham? Then you know that the enemy always tried to mimic God. But he's not going to reveal, the enemy's not going to reveal what he is doing. But it will be considered hidden. Are you hearing me? And if it is hidden, then it is in darkness. And if it's in darkness, it's considered night. Are you listening? Thank you, Father. Glory to God. Now, go back to Judges and let us do this. Go back to Judges now. Go back to Judges. Here we go. Judges chapter 4. And it is also leading up to Palm Sunday. That's why I had to make sure I came on here before Palm Sunday. Why? Because Palm Sunday is a sign and a token to us. Yes, Jesus has already come. Jesus has already been crucified, and Jesus has already been risen. Come on here and sit it at the right hand of the Father and intercedes on our behalf. Are you listening? Glory to God. But we are to do what? Memorize or memorialize, amen, what Jesus has done. And Palm Sunday, glory to God, is coming up on us, because not only is Palm Sunday coming up on us, but guess what? Passover. Are you hearing me? So I don't want to go too fast, but it all is in conjunction. It is all linked together, because Jesus says, I'm the light. I came in the midst of darkness. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. To do what? To reveal the plots and the plan of Satan. Is anybody listening, or did everybody go home? Judges chapter 4. Here we go. I've already gave you the background on Deborah, who she is. She's a prophetess, she's a wife, and she's a judge. Okay, now watch this. Verse 5. And she dwelt under the palm tree. We're going into Palm Sunday. She dwelt under. She dwelt. That is letting us know that is a boundary. That's why a lot of prophets is running around and they saying this, and a lot of us, glory to God, that is not, amen, in tune with God like we should. We grabbing all these prophetic words when there's a lot of errors out there of the prophets. She dwelt. It's showing you it is a boundary. Are you hearing me? It is a boundary. The enemy knows ranking, but we don't want to know ranking in the spirit. We just want to know God told me to do it. God called me to do it, and you can't stop me. Come on here. But the enemy knows. She dwelt. It gave you a boundary. She dwelt. She was positioned. Are you listening? Glory to God. And she dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah. I said, wait a minute, God. She is Deborah. But she dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah. Huh? I said, wait a minute, God, she is Deborah. So did you not, amen, call the tree that she was up under, which was a palm tree, Deborah? He said, no, watch this. Go to Genesis 35. A palm tree is a symbol of triumph over death. And again, I said, in the night, symbolic, biblically, it means death. Are you hearing me? A symbol of triumph over death. And it gives you victory. It also signifies, this is palm, and then we hit tree, palm. It also signifies resurrection, ascension, and transition. Are you hearing the Lord? Glory to God. Palms were routine used in celebration of military exploit with the triumph procession. That's why when you read in the scripture, when Jesus came, they laid down the what? The palms from the tree. They laid down the palms because it was a military move, which was all considered dealing with a battle. Dealing with a battle. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? It was a military move. It was also saying, glory to God, victory. It was also saying triumph over death. Are you hearing me? And death, come on here, Psalms, and we shall be the shadow of death. The shadow of death. The Lord will keep us from the shadow of death. Are you hearing me? And the shadow of death has darkness to it. All right, Deborah, what of the night? So Deborah dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah. It's not talking about Deborah. It's letting us know where she was positioned at. It was letting us know the boundary that she had, glory to God, to stay in. So here we go, Genesis 35 and 8. Let's go there. Genesis 35 and 8. If you are on here, if you're about to come on here, and we are already off, and you are sitting, and you are listening, and your baby is leaping, that is because God is making you aware, glory to God, that you're not like everybody. And if you keep moving with God and keep walking with God and keep obeying God, He's going to reveal who you really are. He's going to reveal who you really are. And there are some people that's on here. You're not just a prophet. You're not just a prophetess. Are you hearing me? Glory to God of Osiah. You all, some of you all, some, not everybody. Everybody cannot be a judge. Everybody cannot be an apostle. Everybody cannot be a pastor. Everybody cannot, y'all get it? So everybody cannot be a judge. But there are people that God has his hands on. You're not just a prophet. You're not just a prophetess. You have a judge mantle on you with the prophet. And you are commanding. You're commanding. Not commanding your morning only. Anybody could command their morning. You speak faith. Are you hearing me? You speak the things of God. You speak the word of God. We all are supposed to do that. But I'm talking about, glory to God, there are positions and ranking in the realm of the spirit that is now time that we arise and we begin to tell the people what is going on in the night. Not your promotion, amen, on your job, but what is going on in the high places. Are you hearing me? Lord, in the high places that we don't know nothing about. Because CNN don't know everything. CNN is not tapped in to the rim of the spirit. Are you hearing me? My God, from Zion, and I'm on shot, ABC, NBC, any other type of news. They only going to say what they see. Are you hearing me? Glory to his wonderful name. But there is something else, glory to Namosi, that we, whom God has anointed and appointed, glory to Namoshi, and has been, my God, from Zion, has been dealing with you strongly. And God is saying it's now time, because those that he's bringing from around the mountain, he's bringing a whole lot of people from around the mountain. But we need to understand, while we're coming from around the mountain and about to be revealed, you better know where you're supposed to be at in the realm of the spirit. You better know what you're supposed to be doing in the realm of the spirit, and you better know your functionings, and you better know your rankings. Because this hour, glory to God, if you do things that you now have not have access to, you're going to be like the sons of Sceva. Is anybody listening, or did everybody go home? So the Bible says over here that Deborah sat, dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah. Genesis 35 and 8. But Deborah, Rebekah's nurse, died. And she was buried beneath Bethel under an oak. Are y'all getting this? And the name of it was called Alon Bakath, the oak of weeping. That's what that means. Now, so over in Judges chapter 4, it tells us the boundary of where Deborah dwelt, where he shot out of Ohio. But in Genesis 35, it tells us who the other Deborah was. These are two different Deborahs. This other Deborah was the nurse to, my God, from Zion, was the nurse to Rebekah. Lord have mercy. She was the nurse to Rebekah, and she died. She passed. Are you hearing me? And she was buried beneath Bethel. She was buried beneath Bethel. And to you all, you know what Bethel means. It means the house of God. And if it's the house of God, it also means the presence of God. Are you hearing me? And it was under an oak. In Judges, this tree, which is an oak tree, glory to God, was called a palm tree. An oak tree is a high tree and a strong tree. Are you hearing me? My God, from Zion, and its roots go deep. Woo, I needed a greeter right there. So Deborah dwelt under, glory to God, the palm tree of Deborah. That's not the same person. Genesis 35 verse 8 told you that. Are you hearing me? Glory to his wonderful name. Yes, yes, yes. And guess what? Go to Genesis 24. Go to Genesis 24. Go to Genesis 24. My God, from Zion. Genesis 24 and verse 59. My God. And they sent, this is Genesis 24 and verse 59, and they sent away Rebekah, their sister, and her nurse. Well, then who was her nurse? Deborah. Then how did Rebekah's nurse get in the Bible? Because, my God, down the road, the Lord was going to have, my God, prophetess, Deborah, Amen. Watch this. The judge. Come on here. The commander. The one that has a military. Glory to God. See, mind of all of the anointed upon her life. He already knew that this was going to play a significant part in the word of God, in the journey of God. Are you hearing me? And so he sits here. Who sits here? The Lord sits here and put Rebecca's nurse in the scriptures. My God, from Zion. She's in the scripture because she leaves with Rebecca to go to Isaac. Rebecca married Isaac, and it says here that she, who is she? Rebecca took her nurse, and over in, glory to God, over in 35, it tell you the name of the nurse. The name of the nurse of Rebecca was Deborah, and where Deborah in Judges chapter 4 sat was up under the same tree that they had buried, my God, Deborah, glory to God, which was Rebecca's nurse, and they, mind, see, I gotta keep saying it, because this is some good stuff to me. This is just, Lord have mercy. And her nurse and Abraham's servant and his men, they sent her away. This is the time where the Lord, where Abraham was telling his right-hand man, my son cannot get a wife from this camp. It must be from another camp. And so he sends him on an assignment, a journey. And so he goes, and glory to God, and God does his thing and meets up. And here it is, Rebecca. Rebecca is the one that God chose for Isaac. Well, in the scripture, the nurse was added. But the nurse at that time in Genesis 24:59, she didn't have a name. She just was called nurse. But in Genesis 35 verse 8, she had a name, and her name was Deborah. Glory to God. And Deborah, it already told us that Deborah, glory to God, passed or died. Abba Shanda. And then in Judges chapter 4, here is the Lord now bringing in this time, glory to God, her name is Prophetess Deborah, which is a judge, and she's now dwelling, and she's positioned. Her boundary is right there, Lord, what the presence of the Lord is. He puts you in a place where he puts you in a place, glory to God, so you could begin to see in the night and begin to reveal and to tell the people you cannot move out of your boundary, because if you move out of your boundary, you will not be able to see, glory to God, to what God is saying concerning the night watch. What happens in the night from a judge standpoint? I'm not just talking about watchmen. I'm not just talking about those that pray. Are you hearing? We all are supposed to be praying. We all supposed to be crying out to God. Are you hearing me? Intercessors are watchmen. Are you hearing me? We are supposed to be watchmen. But I'm talking about ranks now. Glory to God. She is a prophetess, which is a judge. Are you hearing me? And she dwelt up under the palm tree. And I already first stated what a palm symbolizes. A triumph over death. Death is considered a night situation. Are you listening? Death. Triumph over death and brings in what? Victory. It also signifies resurrection and ascension. We're going into what? Resurrection season. Ooh, we're going into Passover season. Look how God is bringing this thing into alignment. Watchmen, what of the night? Is that a boshanda? What of the night? And so it says, 25:59, it says that she was the oak tree, which is considered the palm tree. Are you hearing me? And it said it was what? El Bethel. It is the house of God, or the presence of God, a bowl right there. And so when the Lord placed the prophetess Deborah, he placed her up under this tree, which was considered a palm tree, but it had some history. This particular place had some history. This particular place had some connection. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? A lot of us out here that call ourselves prophets, you have no history. You have no connection with the past in the biblical standpoint of it. You have it up on what you're saying, but you have no biblical history. You have no connection in the biblical sense. Are you hearing me? My God, Deborah, she had history. Where she was at, it was a biblical history. She was linked to a biblical history. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? And the Lord said, you're getting ready to see, because you're not just a prophetess. You are a prophetess, and you are considered a judge, and you will command the military. My God, you will array the people, and you will begin to allow how far a war is supposed to go. I'm getting ready to show you. I'm getting ready to show you. I'm getting ready to show you. So now you see that. You see what I saw. It says Deborah and Deborah. And she dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah. It's not hers. It's not hers. I know it looked like it, but when you go into the scripture, it'll show you there was a different Deborah. This was Rebecca's nurse. Glory to God, out of Oshiah. And they planted her. Cemetery, so you know, right there. And yet and still, God used that place. God used that place. And she had a boundary. Are you hearing me? You got to learn how to have boundaries in your life. Listen, don't do what everybody else doing. Don't be in error like everybody else, because we need to know what is of the night. We need to know what is of the night. What is it that everybody else is seeing this? Have y'all ever seen this commercial? Was dealing with the little oranges, the little halos. And on the commercials, they had many different commercials. Well, one of them was that it was these kids, and they was like, "We're going to the circus to this other little girl." And they were saying, because they wanted her to join in with them. And they said, "We're going to the circus. You need to go with us." And she has the halo, which is the orange, in her hand. And so it's either she go with them or she choose the orange. That's really the main plot of it. But watch this. And so she chooses the orange. But then she's walking past. And now they're showing that these two little girls that had asked her to go so she can go into a place that she didn't know nothing about. Going to a place that she didn't know what was really going to happen. Well, they show her having the orange, and that she chose the orange, and she was eating the orange, and then showed the two that asked her to go that they was up on this barbed wire, and they was doing crazy stuff. They was considering a circus. They was doing crazy stuff. Well, let me tell you something. That's what happens when you don't know what's in the night, and you start joining stuff, and you start connecting yourself to things that you don't know nothing about. That's in the night. That's in the dark. What of the night? Tell me what of the night. What is it? Listen. I always say this to the Father. When I come in connection with somebody, especially a connection with somebody, and they said, you know, you're my wife, or you know, I want to marry you, or whatever the case may be. I'm always saying, God, I need you to show me the good. I need you to show me the good, the bad, and the ugly. Are you hearing me? Because I need to know what of the night. I need to know what it is. I see the frame. I see this. I see that. I see all that, and all that looks good. The cake looked good, but I don't want to eat this cake. And then the cake, my God, the cake don't even taste the way it looked. Y'all not saying that. So I need to know what of the night. I need to know what of the night. So give me the good, the bad, and the ugly. I know what they talking. I know they talking swell words. I know they saying this and they saying that. But I need to see the good, the bad, and the ugly. I need to see what of the night. I need to see what's behind this person. I need to see what. Come on. Are you hearing me? I always say that. I don't care if it's connection of a friend, connection of somebody talking about I'm their wife, whatever the case may be. Glory to God, going to a job, whatever. I need to know what of the night. What of the night? What of the night? Watchmen, what of the night? What of the night? What a be so called bullshit now? Because when you get into something or get down the road into it, glory to God, you should have already begin to say, God, what of the night? And then I'm going to see Deborah, what of the night? What of the night? What of the night? What of the night? You will miss a whole lot of stuff if you realize, glory to Oshiah, you would have asked God the right questions. Are you hearing me? Deborah, what of the night? Are y'all listening? Oh, let me see what my time is. Yes, I got to get ready to go. I held y'all long enough. Amen. Yes, I did. Glory to God. Watch scripture. And the Bible says, and she, I'm in verse 6. Because the enemy don't want y'all to hear this, but it's going to be all right. Verse 6 says, And she sent and called Barak, the son of Abner, out of Kadesh, Naphtaliah, and said unto him, Hath not the Lord God of Israel commanded? She was a commander. She not coming to ask. She's coming to command. Are you hearing me? Well, there you go, child. You just trying to be all strong. You are just trying to. She was a commander. Did not the Lord command you? Woo! Saying, go and draw toward Mount Tabor. And take with thee 10,000 men of Naphtaliah and of the children of Zebulun. Did not the Lord command? I'm coming to command. I'm coming to command. Command you get up. Command you move. Command you do what God has called you to do. Come on here. Well, you act like you my mama. No. Because I know who I am in the spirit. This ain't about your mama. Ain't about your daddy. It's about watchmen. What of the night? I needed a greeter right there. And a commander, if you go into military, a commander ain't playing with nobody. A commander, can you please take that gun over there and then you can sit it over there? Commander ain't talking like that. Are you hearing me? A commander is not talking like that. She didn't ask Barack how you feel. Watchman, what of the night? I'm getting ready to tell you something. While you sitting over here and don't think it's time to go to war, and you think it ain't time to go to battle, and you think it ain't time to be seeing what you can't see, because the blessings is good. Are you hearing me? The blessings is flourishing. The promises are flourishing. Come on here. All that God has said is flourishing. But God said, tell my people to stay on alert while all this stuff is happening. Tell them, don't go to sleep. That's right, Genesee. A commander is aggressive. Aggressive. You too hard. No, it ain't hard. It ain't hard. It's watchmen. What in the night? And God is blessing us. And God is opening up doors. And God is making ways. And while God is doing all that, he is saying, daughter, go and tell my people. Don't get caught up in the blessings and the promises that forget to say, what of the night? What of the night? What of the night? Are you hearing what the Lord is saying? What of the night? What of the night? Because we need to know. We need to know. And especially that we're seeing all type of stuff happening from the White House and all demonic stuff that's happening in the natural. If you can see all that in the natural, and those that are saved are seeing it too, there's something that is being put together right now as I'm speaking. Are you hearing me? She, who is she? Deborah says to Barack, did not God command you while you over there and you enjoying your day to go? It's time for war. It's time for war. It's time, and go and deal with something that is already getting ready to come your way. But before it can get to you, you should already be there destroying it. But you will never know that if there is no watchman. What of the night? The prophets of Israel, the prophets, the judges. This is what I'm talking about. We're calling for the prophets, the judges now. We're calling for the prophets, the judges, to arise, to arise, to arise. Had not the Lord of Israel commanded, saying, go and draw to a Mount Tabor and take with thee 10,000? Because guess what? The Bible says she was sitting up under this tree. She didn't go find him. Because she had a boundary. She didn't go find him. He had to come to her. He had to come to her. Are you hearing me? He came to her. Everybody that had to come up and come to her. Come up to her for judgment. Come up to her for her to judge. Come up. Are you hearing me? Come up. That's why I keep hollering and saying, get out of the shallow water. Get out of the shallow water. You know that. But God is talking deeper to you. Get out of the shallow water and come to the deepness of God. The deep is calling for the deep things of God. They had to come up for her to judge them. Why? Because she was a judge and she could see of the night. Are y'all getting this? Are y'all getting this? Are you getting this? Verse 14, scribes. And Deborah said unto Barak, up. You don't have time. And this is what gets me. Because we always think we got time. No, we're going to have to get to the point. But I don't trust everybody, Apostle Jackson. I hear what you said, and I love you, girl, and all that. But I don't trust everybody. And you're not supposed to trust nobody but God. Are you hearing me? Trust no man. Put your trust in no flesh. But if you got a true relationship with God, and you begin to realize that seasons have changed, times have changed, and I'm not talking about in the natural realm. When God comes to say to you, it's time for you to shift and turn and go this way. Well, God, you know what? I need to make sure that the weather is right. I need to make sure my money is taken care of. I need to make sure, you know, God, give me time to make sure all this is taken care of. You know, that's how we do. Because God ain't going to just throw stuff on you like that. You know, God, you know, he wants us to use some wisdom. Okay? She told Barak, God commanded you to get up. And then in verse 14, it says, and Deborah said unto Barak, up, up. For this is the day in which the Lord had delivered Sisera into thine hand. Is not the Lord gone out before thee? So Barak went down from Mount Tabor and 10,000 men after him. He didn't even know. He didn't even know. And you have to understand, he was saying, I'm not going without you. I need my watchman. I need my watchman. I can see some stuff there, but there's some stuff I can't see. I need my watchman. That's what Barak said. And verses after, verses six after that, he said, if you don't go, I'm not going. I need my watchman. I need my judge. I know you're a prophet, but I need the judge that I've also said that has access. You're the commander. She went to Barak, and Barak was the military. It was military. It was time for war. Are y'all getting this? And he told her, if you're not going, because I need my watchman. Well, you need to pray yourself. No, listen. Keep your prayer life. You got to have a personal prayer life that keeps you in tune with God, that keeps you to have a relationship with God. But there is assignments that is out there in the realm of all this activity that is going on, that God has granted access to certain people that he has not granted access to all. Are y'all getting this? I'm not telling you to stop praying. You got to keep praying. You got to have a personal relationship with God. I'm talking about the rankings. I'm talking about, man, I'm outside, military activities in the realm of the spirit, if y'all didn't know that. I'm not telling you to stop praying. Boo. I'm not going to stop praying for nobody. I'm going to pray. That keeps me in tune with God. But there is places in the earth you don't have access to. And somebody else has the right credentials that have that access to that. Are y'all getting this? It's not hard. We as the body of Christ, we make everything hard. It is not hard. It is not hard. I'm trying to tell you that the prophets, the judges are about to arise. That's what I'm saying. And I'm saying that she didn't go asking him. She said, up. I'm commanding you. Up. Get up. I'm commanding you. Today is the day. The Lord has already went out before you. Why are you still waiting around? Why are you still sitting here? Why are you still contemplating? Why are you still talking about, well, I don't know, I don't think this is the Lord. That ain't what he said. That ain't what he said. Go to verse 23. It's a long chapter. You read it. I got to go. So the Lord got subdued on that day, Jabin the king of the Canaan, before the children of Israel. So what happened that day? Because the she can see, because she was up. She wasn't just a prophetess. She was a judge. She was a commander. Are you hearing me? And she knew how to deal with the activities in the second realm as well as in the third. The third realm is where the heavens is at. But it's the second realm. Are you hearing me? And you have to understand, glory to God, she told him, now you're going to get up. Let me shut this because I'm done. You're going to get up and you're going to do this. But the victory is not coming in your hand. It's going to be a woman. It's going to be a woman. And the Bible makes it plain, give the story, that this woman the king ran into her tent. She was married. He runs into the tent. He said, listen, I got some people chasing me. Hide me in here. If they come and inquire and ask you if I'm in here, tell them no. But Deborah knew what of the night. Deborah knew what of the night. See, Barak didn't even know that the enemy was headed to his house. Barak didn't even know that the enemy was headed to Israel. But because there was a watchman, are you hearing me? I need them to hear me so clearly, guys. I'm not talking about anything of a house, of a car, of a job. I am talking about what is going on at the top of the governor, the White House. Are y'all getting this? What I'm talking about is dealing with that the United Kingdom, that the very thing that heads are getting ready to sit at tables and getting ready to make decisions. And you all can keep hollering, come on, that's over there now, that's over there in that country, that's over there in that country. We get ready to get out of here. It's coming over here to America. It's coming over here to America. When the Lord revealed to me they're going to be concentrated camps, and I began to minister it on Tuesday night, somebody sent me a clip. I didn't open it. I just read a little bit of it. And the clip was dealing with concentrated camps and began to show me what it was connected with, because God said it. I'm going to preach whatever God tells me to preach. If God tells me to come on here and preach that you're going to be healed, I'm going to preach that. If God tells me to come on here and to preach that God is going to cause unity to come back, I'm going to preach that. If God tells me to come on here and to preach that he just opened up doors, I'm going to preach that. And if God tells me to come on here and tell the people, watchmen, what of the night, and then he's getting ready to reveal his judges, the prophets, the judges, I'm going to preach that. I'm not just a one-sided preacher. I'm a full-circle preacher. Is anybody listening? And if you can only handle the blessings and the promises, then you're in a bad place, because you should want to be a well-round Christian, a well-round believer, knowing that when they begin to say peace, all hell should break loose. But why would you hear them say peace and then hell break loose and then you wasn't prepared? You need to know, how do I prepare? What do I need to do? So this will not come nigh me. And I'm telling you, Deborah, what of the night? Deborah was sitting in a place. She didn't go to them. They had to come to her. And they didn't come on the same level because she was up. They had to come up. You got to come up. That's why I keep telling y'all, get up off the shoreline and get out here into the deep. Get out here to the deep. I'm telling you that today is the day that the Lord is saying to us, there is something that is coming on this earth. And while we look at it as a physical something, God said, no, y'all behind schedule. Y'all should have known. Now you can say, and the Lord will reveal his secrets to the prophets. Come on now. Because everything is not a secret of God. It could be the secret of the enemy. And that's what God is talking about. The secret of the enemies. Are you hearing me? The warfare. Our warfare is not kind of a mighty thing, pulling down a stronghold, all that good stuff. The second realm of activity. Are you getting this? Are you understanding this? Watchmen, what of the night? This was a military. This is a military story right here. Judges chapter 4. It's a military story. It's a military story. And she knew how to array people. And she knew how far the war was supposed to be. Why? Because she told Barak. She told Barak, this, it's not going to be by your hand. But you need to get up. But it won't be by your hand. God has already went out before you. This thing is headed your way, but you need to already get up and go and head to it and take it. But it won't be by your hand. It's going to be by another woman. And I'm not trying to say it's a woman thing, a man thing. Y'all need to hear me in the spirit. Don't be putting me in that mess. I ain't in that mess. I am not in that type of category. A woman thing, a man thing. No, it's a God thing. It's a God thing. I'm just showing you the characters. Are you hearing me? It's a God thing. Ain't a woman thing. Ain't no man thing. That ain't even me. Are you hearing me? And so she says to him, it's a woman. And the woman sitting at home, minding her business, and the king runs up in there and said, if anybody come looking for me, don't tell them. She said, cool. She said, let me make you comfortable. Let me make this enemy that's been an enemy to Israel comfortable. And so the king asked for water. That was he was so cray cray. He asks her, let me turn this off for a second. He asks her for water. She give him milk. That should have been a sign right there to him that she wasn't on his side. He said, can you give me some water? She said, yeah, I'll give you some. And gave him milk, warm milk. What does warm milk do? Put someone to sleep. Come on. She meant for him to go to sleep. She meant for him to rest. Are you hearing me? Because this enemy that was on its way to take Israel out, was going to be destroyed. Why? Because watchmen, what are the night? We no longer need, amen, death or anything, amen, that the enemy will conjure up, get to our house and overtake. And there is no judges of the prophets that can see and begin to speak it. And I'm not just talking about glory to his wonderful name. Stuff that just in the community. I'm talking about stuff that is happening from the top that we don't know nothing about, because there will be concentrated camps. There will be, because why? Hitler was a fleshly man that was possessed by demons. Are y'all kidding this? So when Hitler, the flesh man, died, the spirit didn't die. Are y'all getting this? Are you getting this? And it did not go and just sat down. It went to get something greater. It was against the Jews. Y'all, what's wrong? Hello? It was against the Jews. So therefore, that spirit didn't just go and sit down and say, oh, well, we got defeated. Oh, well, okay, no. It left him, Hitler, went and said, you know what? We're going to sit here and we're going to wait for some years. But we're going to counter up. And when all this disasters and stuff happen, and certain things come out and say, you know, I'm helping. So, you know, send your money here because we're going to help, because disasters of the events of the floods and the events of the hurricanes and different things of that nature. Glory to God. You got to understand something is about to happen. Something is about to happen. And you have to be aware, and to you all, I'm waking you up that have the prophet mantle on you, the office of the prophet, and you have walked in a judge and don't even know it. What of the night? The top will be cut down, okay? The top will be cut down, okay? It's going to be cut down, you're right. But it's going to be cut down from those that's in the right rankings. Are y'all getting this? The right rankings. I need you to hear me in the spirit. I need you to hear me in the spirit. I need you to hear me in the spirit. I was speaking to my brother the other day, and I said, and we were driving, and I said to him, I said, there's a lot of Caucasian prophets that are judges. They are speaking this already. But to the African Americans, all we want, and ain't everybody, okay? All we want to do, tell me about a house. Tell me about a car. Tell me about, you know, a job, and we don't want to know the totality. Tell me about Nananamoshaya. And then I told y'all the other day that that started as a serpent, the snake. It is what? A reptile. Am I talking right? Is not a snake a reptile? Am I talking right? Somebody tell me, what is a snake? Is he not in the reptile family? Is he not in the reptile family? The snake is in the reptile family, right? All right. So if in Genesis he starts off still a deceiver. Still a deceiver. Okay, he starts off in the snake form, but it's still a deceiver, still the enemy, the spirit. Are y'all getting this? Now, the Lord God curses the snake and say, you no longer will walk. You will crawl on your belly, right? Then he bring judgment to the woman. He bring judgment to Adam, right? All right. Then if that spirit started at the beginning, then it had to mature. It is maturing. And when you hit over into Revelation, he has now become what? The dragon. Come on, somebody. So if it started off like this, it matured itself. It has matured itself. And this is what African Americans, we gonna miss it. And we don't want to listen to the Caucasians or the Spanish people that got this thing, that they're judges of the prophets are real. Oh, the handful of us that listen, a handful of us that inquire, oh my God, what did you say? Give this to me deeper. Oh my God. No, because all we want to do is jump and shout. All we want to do is run around a church and say, that's my word, and then leave the house of God, and it doesn't do nothing with it. And again, I'm not saying it's everybody, but because I'm a leader, I see this. I'm speaking on the perspective of from a leader, not the perspective, oh, it's your church. No, as a leader, it is so much more to this. Are you hearing me? And so Revelation no longer calls it a snake. He calls it a dragon. Come on, somebody. Which means it has matured. It has grown up. Are you hearing me? And it is always, if you even read Daniel, it's all talking about territorial. It's talking about heads. And we know it's demons and all that. But where is it sitting at? Where? It's all about military. And we're going to get this together, and we're going to have a true balance in our life. Amen. It is now time for the judges of the prophets to arise. It is now time. Why? Because what of the night? This story of Judges chapter 4 of Deborah and Barak is dealing with military function. Are you hearing me? And what I love about this story is that she commanded and put everybody in array to where they needed to be on the battlefield. And she also knew how long the war. This thing did not drag on. She knew how long the war was supposed to be. Are you hearing me? She knew. The enemy coming in our life, and he come in and supposed to touch this. And then he turns around. And he didn't went all through our lives, all through our homes, all through our marriages, all through our businesses, all through our children. He wasn't supposed to do all that. We need to know. We need to know the extent of the war. We need to know. I'm going to leave out of here with this. I got to go. And so the conclusion of the matter is Deborah was a military prophetess, judge. I'm telling you what God showed me years and years ago. They're going to be concentrated camps. So much. And God has showed other people stuff. And while we looking over there in foreign country and say, oh, it won't come nigh us. It won't come nigh us if we're not in God like we're supposed to. And the people that are in certain rankings don't get there and start doing what they're supposed to. So we as the body of Christ, the children of God, will miss it. We are going into Palm Sunday. And Deborah was sitting up under a palm tree. The tree signified flowing of revelation. Flowing of revelation speech and nourishment. Are you hearing me? Palm tree is the flourishing or the flowing of revelation and nourishment. I'm going to leave you with this. 2 Corinthians. All I can say is time now. I'm commanding the prophets, the judges of the prophets, to arise now. To arise now. And command what is going on in the night. And what is it that the people of God, the children of God, what we are to do. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. 2 Corinthians, and I'm out of here, chapter 2. And everybody won't get this. Won't understand it. And it's okay. That doesn't stop me from saying and doing what I'm supposed to do and say. Because I got to get it out there. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, as I leave up out of here, verse 9. The Bible decrees the word of God to be so. For to this end also did I write, that I might know the proof of you, whether ye be obedient in all things. To whom you forgive anything, I forgive also. For if I forgave anything, to whom I forgave it, for your sake forgave I it in the person of Christ. Lest Satan should get an advantage of us. For we are not ignorant of his devices. For lest Satan should get an advantage of us. For we are not ignorant of his devices. So what is God saying as we walk up out of here? You better forgive. You better let it go. You better stop trying to hold on to who hurt you, what they did, and all that stuff. Let it go. Why? Because if you hold on to it, you'll never understand when it's time for the watchman to begin to speak of what is of the night. Satan will always have an advantage over you. Because what holds you, according to 2 Corinthians chapter 2, is you have not forgiven. So keep yourself in the posture of that I've forgiven. God, I forgive those that hurt me. I even forgive myself of where I fell. Unless if you don't, Satan will have an advantage of you. And for you and I not to know what's going on in the night will harm our lives, harm our children, harm everything that we're connected to. And we can't have that. Precious, this is the word of God. It was Judges chapter 4. You can read the entirety. It is dealing with militant. Military is dealing with a battle. Are you hearing me? You and I need to know. I see this, but there's something behind this, God, that I can't see. And I need you to make me aware. Deborah, what of the night? Deborah, what of the night? And she didn't ask Barak, could you? She said, did not God command you to get up? And in verse 14, she said, up. It's time now. Today is the day. The enemy is already headed, but we're going to cut him off. Are you hearing what the Lord is saying? And you and I will no longer allow the enemy to run rapid, having a war situation, and he taking on one thing, and then ran rapid through our life because we don't understand how far and how long a war is supposed to be. Well, beloved, not only do you want God to show you behind the scenes, but I'm telling you, there are rankings. There are certain things God is not just going to show us just because we are saved. There are certain things he holds for those that he put in position. That's why it's always a fight. God ain't said it because he ain't showed me. And if God ain't showed me, then you know, because God ain't like that. It is not that God is trying to hold something from you because. But God does not go against his own laws. He don't go against what he already laid down. And that's why African Americans will always have problems, because they don't want to understand how God does a thing and what God does. We always got to have something to say and don't understand. God said, I got rankings in the realm of the spirit. The enemy has rankings. I must have fell out last night when the man of God said that. I said, please tell the people. Satan has rankings. I'm out. Archangel Michael, Archangel Gabriel, and used to be Archangel Lucifer, but he's no longer an archangel in that type of realm. Those was ranking saints. Now, if the Lord got angels, then what he got in the earth that will what represent? So the housing of that type of anointing, that type of power, can begin to walk in the earth. It has to take in the body. Y'all, come on. That's why I said, come up out of that shallowness. Y'all too shallow. Half of y'all too shallow. I see a whole lot of stuff going on and people doing a whole lot of stuff, and I just be looking and say, God, please help us. Help us, Lord. We touching stuff, we doing stuff, we saying stuff, and you ain't give us the green light, you ain't give us the access, you haven't even called us to that type of ranking. Come on. And the police force. Y'all, come on. Come on. You got those that are coming from going into boot camp. Boot camp people can't even talk to people that are sergeants and all that type of stuff the way they think they can talk. Y'all, come on. I'm just trying to wake us up. It's more to this than what we think. It's more to this. And God said, Deborah, what of the night? This is a military scripture. This is a battle. This is, come on. So what, the enemy was going to come and overtake and take them out. He started running for his life. That's why he ran into the tent and told the lady, if anybody come this way, say, nope, you ain't seen me. She's okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And she took him out. She took the head out. I love y'all. It's more to this. We getting ready to get up out of here. It's more to this. If you think that's all God is saying, I'm going to give you a house, I'm going to give you a car, then why are there satanic men and women in the pulpit and they're speaking in the name of the Lord, but they're not of God? And we hollering, got our hands up, and we running all over the church and saying that's God. And they're satanic. Y'all better come on. Come on, somebody. Go back, listen to 1 and 2, and then bring it all in to 3. Come on. And if except God discern and reveal it, you wouldn't even know that they satanic. Come on here. They sound like God. They look like God. Oh, my God. The gifts of the Spirit is in operation, but it's not of God. Gifts and calling coming out of repentance. There are things that are about to hit the earth. Come on, y'all. We're going to be like everybody else and then get the information when CNN get it. We're going to get the information when ABC get it. We're going to get the information when CBS, when everybody in the world get it. No. Oh, y'all, come on. Come on. Watchmen, Deborah, the prophetess, the judge. What of the night? I love y'all. I love y'all. I love y'all. I gotta go. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, by the working power of the Holy Spirit, I pray, Father, that you will begin to deal even the more with us regarding this, Lord God. Because there is something that's coming up on the earth. And Father, I pray now that you will begin to reveal it. And then I'm on shy. For this thing, is in a place that's dealing with the military. And so, Father, I thank you. I thank you, Father, that you're getting ready to reveal. And then when they come and make this a kingdom, this one thing, coming into a circle and sit with all these heads from different countries and stuff, and begin to plot to take out stuff, I pray that you begin to reveal. And that us, your people, Israel, the spiritual Israel, that we were here, take heed, and begin to do what you told us to do. Now, God, I pray that you begin to start dealing with your prophets that you have called to be judges in this hour to arise and begin to see in the night like they're supposed to see, and begin to speak it and warn the people up on a national and international level. Father, I thank you because it is so. In Jesus' name, cover us in your blood. Keep us, protect us. In Jesus' name. Well, beloved, my time is up. I love you. Don't forget, if you're in the Irving area tomorrow, Sunday, 12:30, we're going to have a high time. This was the conclusion of the matter. Deborah, what of the night? What of the night? Yeah. I can't be so bullshit. So you be encouraged. I love you. I send kisses, love, and hugs again all around the world. If you go with God, God, he'll go with you. May the blessings of the Lord make you rich, and it add no sorrow. And to those that asked me to pray, I'm going to go back and look at what you said, and I'm going to pray. I'm going to pray with you. I'm going to pray for you and pray that the will of the Lord be done for your life. Until next time, Deborah, what of the night? Blessings.